I'm Cece Reeder. I'm a registered dietitian with Kanima Fitness. In honor of October being National Breast Cancer Awareness Month, I'm here to provide some women's health nutrition tips along with a recipe for chickpea lentil soup. Females are more likely to be deficient in iron than males. Because of this, I wanted to create a recipe that was high in iron, a balanced meal, and can help an individual either maintain or lose weight. Like I mentioned, October is National Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Although there is no way to completely prevent this disease, maintaining a healthy weight, incorporating more fruits and vegetables into the diet, and adding a fitness routine all can help reduce risk factors. Early detection of breast cancer is key. In the attached recipe card, I've included resources for those who might be interested in learning more about early detection, mammograms, self-examinations, and also additional risk factors. On that note, let's get cooking. All the ingredients for today's recipe can be found on the attached recipe card. I've already gone ahead and washed the spinach, so I've placed it in a salad spinner just so that we can dry it off. Spinach is a great source of non-heme iron, potassium, and vitamins A and vitamin K. Non-heme iron is the plant source iron, and heme iron is found in animal products. So items like eggs and chicken and beef are great sources of heme iron. This non-heme iron isn't as absorbable in our body as the heme iron, so we want to add something with vitamin C to help with the absorption rate. So in today's recipe, we're going to add some tomatoes, which are high in vitamin C. My tomatoes are already washed, so I'm going to get started with dicing them for this soup. Like I said, tomatoes are high in vitamin C, so that's going to help with the absorption of the non-heme iron. But tomatoes are also high in lycopene. So lycopene is a phytonutrient or a phytochemical that gives the tomato the red color, that pigmentation. So lycopene actually has some research behind it showing that there's properties helping to reduce the risk of cancer. The phytochemical in tomatoes giving it that antioxidant property is lycopene, but every color produce is gonna have a different phytochemical. So on carrots, we're gonna have beta carotene. When it comes to beta carotene, there's no evidence that shows that it helps to prevent or reduce the risk of cancer, but it does help to improve the immune system. There is a study that shows that toxic levels of beta carotene, which you can receive from supplements, not from eating too much carrots, can actually have dangerous effects, including increasing the risk of cancer. So be wary about some of the supplements that are on the market for beta carotene. One of the best ways to ensure that a meal is satiating is to make it a balanced meal. Balanced meals include a lean source of protein, a whole grain, and fruits or vegetables. Proportions and portions of these different groups will be dependent on the individual, but a general rule of thumb is to make it 25% lean protein, 25% whole grain, and 50% fruits or vegetables. So with this, we definitely have the fruits and vegetables covered, and we're gonna add 3/4 a cup of dried lentils for some extra plant-based proteins and some extra fiber. We're also gonna have some chickpeas. It's a can of chickpeas that I've already gone ahead and rinsed. And then we also have some quinoa, and I've already gone ahead and cooked this quinoa. Quinoa itself is a whole grain, but it's also a complete protein. Plant-based proteins typically are incomplete by themselves, and you wanna add something like a chickpea and a lentil with a fruit or vegetable or maybe a whole grain. But because quinoa is complete all by itself, we don't need to add anything to make it a complete protein. We can talk a little bit more about that in future recipe videos. So like I said, quinoa is a complete protein, so that's going to be our protein source, but it's also a great source of fiber, folate, and B6. So it's a great addition to this little recipe. And then we have the stars of our shows, lentils and chickpeas. So these are both high in non-heme iron, and they also are really high in fiber. Fiber is awesome to include into your meals and can be in these food sources or also in vegetables and fruit. So fiber will help the food stay in our stomach a little bit longer before going through the whole digestion process. So that makes us feel fuller for a longer period of time. It also will help us maintain our blood sugar, and fiber is going to be very helpful in helping reduce risk for many different chronic diseases. Now that we have all of our ingredients prepared, we're going to go ahead and start with the cooking component. Now that we're ready to start cooking, I have my pot on the stove and my stove is brought up to medium heat, and we're going to saute our carrots first. So I have some olive oil and I'm just going to drizzle it into the pot so I can get the carrots started. I'll dump the carrots in here. If you want to add some onions, you are welcome to dice them up and add them to this. And I'm also going to add a little bit of just minced garlic just to taste. Okay, so I'll let this saute for a little bit. And then once your onions are a little translucent, if you're adding your onions, and once your carrots start to look like they're at a good consistency, then we'll move on to the next step. So my carrots are starting to cook. They're looking good. I'm just gonna go ahead and add some spices. I'm personally just gonna add a little bit of paprika. And then a little bit of garlic powder to my soup. You are welcome to add that if you'd like, or you can add a different kind of spice depending on what direction you wanna take this soup in. Okay. Starting to look like it's cooked well. So I'm just gonna put it off to the side and then we'll start adding in more ingredients to our soup. Okay, so now we get to add in our dried lentils, our chickpeas, and we also get to add in our vegetable broth. I purchased a store-bought vegetable broth just to make it a little bit easier on myself, but I looked for a low sodium type. I looked at the nutrition facts label to help me determine which one was actually low in sodium, because sometimes the marketing can be a little bit misleading. My go-to little tip for low sodium food items is to look at the percent daily value. If the percentage on the percent daily value is 5 and below, then that means you're good to go. 10 or above, it's a little high. And in between 5 and 10, that's up to you to determine whether that is high for you or not. You can always speak with a registered dietitian to figure out if, you know, maybe in that mid-range you should avoid or you should limit. And it also might be dependent on what food it is. So especially since we have the dried lentils in here, we need to cook those lentils. And so I'm gonna bring the pot up to a boil. So we're gonna turn this stove all the way on. And once it gets to a boil, I'm gonna cover it and let it simmer for a little bit. So my soup is at a boil right now, so I'm gonna put the lid on it and then bring it down to a simmer. This is gonna go on for about 20-30 minutes depending on how cooked through it looks. Now that the lentils are nice and tender, I know that the soup is ready for me to add more ingredients into it. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the tomatoes that we chopped up. I'm also gonna add the quinoa. So just a note, if you are planning on freezing the soup to have more long-term, I would recommend adding your grain later on when you're about to reheat it. Otherwise, if you're planning on having it that night or in the more near future and just refrigerating the soup, I would go ahead and add the grain right away, no problem with that. And then now that the quinoa's added, I'm gonna go ahead and add the spinach as well. And then we'll stir it, let it simmer for about a couple more minutes, and then it'll be ready to serve. So now that the spinach has wilted into the soup, it is time to serve and enjoy. looks delicious.